Putin is one of the world's strongest and most powerful politicians. The ex-KGB agent turned politician holds a lot of power in his hands. There is no wonder that security measures to protect the president are jaw-droppingly insane. In this video, we're going to give you a brief rundown of Vladimir Putin's insane security. Before we continue, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell icon for notifications. Let's begin. Vladimir Putin was a worker for countless years in Russia's Federal Security Service before he decided to ascend the political ladder and eventually become president of Russia. Of all the people in the world, Putin would definitely know the value and necessity of heightened protection. He is, after all, a man of many enemies. He has beefed up Presidential Security Service. Though the security organization is largely very secretive, some tidbits have trickled out into the public every now and then. Putin employs an estimated 2,000 to 3,000 plainclothes officers to guard him at all hours of the day, 24/7. They have the responsibility to secure a building that Putin is scheduled to enter. They comb and scrutinize every entry, window, and pathway in the building, making sure it is 100% safe for Putin. They are also tasked to work around the clock to mitigate any sort of threat to Putin's safety. So without wasting any further time, let's move directly into the topic at hand. First of all, anyone lucky enough to be enlisted in Putin's personal security army is often rewarded for all their efforts. Putin understands just how difficult and tiresome it is to start from the very bottom of the ladder and then slowly work your way up to the very top. He always encourages hard work and always rewards those who are actually willing to do the hard work. That is why he supports his Federal Protective Services officers. Since 2016, four FSO officers from his personal guard have actually been promoted to regional governing ranks. This is quite remarkable, to be honest. It is an unusual leap from the shadows straight into public office. A fifth member of his army became the head of the newly formed National Guard. Another was promoted in 2013 to a post in the Defense Ministry. Here, he was allowed to command special forces and reportedly oversaw the operation to annex Crimea. In 2016, he also became the governor of the whole Tula region. Tula, being an arms industry center to the south of Moscow, is considered to be a very, very important place in Russia. It was as if a butler was suddenly made the king. But such promotions should not be considered extraordinary, as they occur pretty often. The officers are Putin's constant companions, and he usually grows to enjoy their company and brotherly bonds are forged. They often serve as his security, as well as his travel buddies and even personal cooks from time to time. This also gives them a chance to rub elbows with the Prussian elite and to try to make a name for themselves in the upper echelons of Russian society. Not all is sweet and sunny, though, with some shady things also happening behind the curtain. Critics have long criticized that these bodyguards and security personnel have been rewarded with a lot of Russian land and unimaginable amounts of wealth. Often people are forced out of their homes to accommodate the massive mansions that Putin's special men get. Some cases also emerge where decorated World War II veterans of the Soviet Army were forced off of their land. The Soviet Union had promised them a lifetime of employment and pensions, but Putin had other ideas. These poor soldiers and workers have been crying since the early 90s at least. A small clique of powerful businessmen, gas company owners, and criminals use forgery, intimidation, and even beatings to seize the land. Moving on to the crazy measures that Putin takes for his own safety. As this is Russia, it does not work like normal countries. You might be surprised to know the president's security team actually has its own company called A-Tech. The company is very strong in Russia and has billions of dollars in total assets owned. Putin spares no expense when it comes to security and protection. His unit has dozens and dozens of armored cars and drones and even a dedicated psychological security unit. This unit collects intelligence regarding any perceived threat either at home or while visiting foreign countries. Putin has been pictured leaving bathrooms in Paris in a towel with at least six bodyguards all around him. Apparently, Putin prefers security over privacy. It is important to keep in mind that the army has its roots in the KGB, the Soviet version of the Secret Service, makes their training grueling and very extensive. Things such as diving to the bottom of Lake Baikal and learning to fly a fighter jet plane are just some of those things. Putin keeps these men in suits as well as lingering all around him in plain clothes. You might not even spot them, but Putin always has at least 10 or so men nearby. Putin has also traveled around in style and security. Putin has a limo which is completely bomb-proof. The limo has been a feature of Putin's and his world tours since May of 2018. He is said to have personally requested that a Russian limo be made rather than relying on any sort of foreign brand, such as Mercedes, as was the norm before. The result of this was the Auris, a brand new company hoping to rival Rolls-Royce. The car is one of a fleet that cost nearly $192 million to develop and has been in production since 2012. While the car can be bought, Putin's car comes with many special little features. His limo can withstand chemical gas attacks and even the strongest fire from a sniper rifle. It even has advanced communications equipment installed all over the car, making it a mobile command center. Two of the four seats in the back are movable, and everything can be monitored by real-time CCTV footage aired on internal screens. An emergency exit is also built in the rear end of the car. The car is covered in armor plating and weighs a total of 6 tons. It runs on a 6.6-liter V12 engine with an estimated horsepower of 860. His security team even releases fake GPS signals in order to confuse any potential threats and enemies. The GPS of ships near the harbor where Putin is traveling always go haywire and lose all sense of direction. The phenomenon suggests that Vladimir travels with a mobile GPS spoof device. This is highly irresponsible and against the law, but Putin gets what Putin wants. There have been reports that nearly 1,311 ships and tankers have been affected by this spoofing. At least 7,910 cases have been detected where victim vessels located outside of Russian territory fell victim to this GNSS spoofing activity. This is an obvious threat to all maritime navigational security. Rumors have also swirled around time after time, stating that Putin has been using a body double for the longest of times. He even admitted himself that a plan actually existed to do this in the early 2000s. This was when Russia was fighting a war in Chechnya. Putin has always been the subject to numerous online hoaxes and rumors, but this one was actually true. Although Putin denied ever accepting the offer to take a body double, we at least know that this is a plan that the Russians have thought about before. So, we all knew that Putin was always been keen to keeping up his strongman persona. But digging just a little bit, we find that the security and safety of the Russian president is a very time and money consuming job. It looks like Putin might just be a little paranoid and will stop at no end to protect himself and secure his life. Putin knows how to rule a country and keep up his image at the same time. He has ruled with an iron fist for such a long time, and it does not look like he will be giving away any of his power for a long, long time to come. His strategy of gifting and practically bribing his buddies and his security team is a surefire way of keeping the ones closest to him happy, and always will do his bidding. This is a great way of exuding total control over the government and its people. The frankly absurd methods and money being used to protect Putin shows that he may not be as strong and carefree as he likes his public persona to be. But with so many potential enemies and killers roaming around, it might just be better to err on the side of safety than to be reckless and leave a room for accidents to happen. That is a wrap for Vladimir Putin's insane security. Which part of his protocol surprised you the most? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.